numbers of one digit of the square root of the numbers. These numbers are given. You have to find out the possible one digit. One digit means, you know, it is unit digit. Means for this number you have to check its unit digit. Here in this number the unit digit is 1. Unit digit of this number is 1. You have to check the possibility of the unit digit of the square root of the numbers. Means here I have written in the table from 1 to 10 squares are written, and with any number only you have to check the possibility. So 1. So let's say given the this table where you will get 1. Aggregating 1 square is 1, another aggregate 9 square is 81. Here the last digit of 1 square is 1, and here the last digit of 9 square is 81. So, what are the possibility of getting the unit digit as 1? It is 1 or 9. So, the answer will be 1 or 9. Similarly, in the second question also you have to see the unit digit. Here the unit digit I am having is 6. Check the possibility in this table where you will get 6. I can get this in 4 square is 16. Again, 6 square is 36. So the possibility of getting unit digit as 6 will be 4 or 6. So the answer will be 4 or 6. This is question number 2. It says that without doing any calculation, find out the number which are surely not perfect square. So in this question, without calculation, we have to find out which numbers are perfect. 51, again subtract 51, minus the next whole number will be 15, you will get 36, again subtract 36 by the next will be 17, you will get 90. Next whole number is 90. So 90 minus 19 is 0. You have to follow this step unless and until you get the 0 here. Now the next step is count the numbers of where you have subtracted. It means this is 1. Count number of steps you until you have got 0. So this is first, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seven, eight, nine, and 10. So here you took 10 steps to solve this repeated subtraction pattern. So this is 10. So the answer will be 10. The square root of 100 is 10. This is question number 4. In this question, you have to find out square root by the prime factorization method. Prime factorization, this method is very easy. You just need to prime factorize the number, find out the vectors, make pairs of the vectors, and you will get the square root. So let's start. This is 7 to 9. This is 3 to 6. 3 4 are 12. 3 3 are 9. 3 8 are 3 1 are 3 2 are 3 7 are 3 9 are 3 3 are and 3 1 are. Write down the factors of 2, 7, 9. I will get 3 into 3 into 3 into 3 into 3 6. 3 into 3. Pair the factors. I will make pairs of 2. This 3 and 3 square means 2 now, so I will make pairs of 2. This 3 is forming 1 pair, this 3 is forming 1 pair, and this 3 is forming 1 pair. So 3 into 27. So here the answer is the square root of this number is 27. Again, in the next question, prime factorize 400. 400 I will get prime factorize by 2. 2 2 is 4. 2 1 is 2 5 is 10. 2 2 is 4. 2 5 is 10. 5 5 is 10. 5 1 is 10. Write out the factors of 400, you will get 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 5 into 5. Make pairs. This is first pair, this is second, and this is third one. Write down the pairs 2 into 2 into 5. 5 to the 10, 10 to the 20. So the answer is 20. The square root of 20 is 20. So the square root is 20. This is prime factorization method. Thus, similarly, there are many questions in this chapter. You have to solve the questions by same following. square, and also find the square root of the square of 8. Means likewise, just we have done in the previous question, same there we have multiplied, here we will divide the number. So the very first step we will try factorize the number. And you will try factorize the number, you will get 1620. 2 8s are 1s are 2 0s are 2 4s are 2 0s are 5s are 3 1s are 3 3s are 3 5s are 3 45 again 3 1s are 3 5s are here we get 15 and here 5 1s are. Write down the factors of 1620. 1620 factors will be